Laudato Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ. My name is Father Paul Samasumo, bringing you live commentary of this encounter between Pope Francis for peace. It's a peace meeting being held in the square, the Nezavisimost Square, the Square of Independence, which was formerly the Square of Lenin. We'd like in a very special way to welcome viewers of CBS TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Net TV, and Catholic TV. It has been a very busy day for the Holy Father today. He spent most of his day in the city of Rakovsky, in the central south of Bulgaria. And now he's back in Sofia as he arrives at this square, the Independence Square, in the presence of representatives of various religious denominations in Bulgaria. This peace meeting is a tangible sign that adopting a culture of dialogue and respect is possible and urgent. Right there in the background, you can hear the famous song popularized and written by Michael Jackson and Lionel Richie, We Are the World, produced by Quincy Jones in 1985, sold more than 20 million copies. In 1985, it was an American benefit song for famine relief in Ethiopia, but it has since become an anthem for the world coming together, aspiring for peace, for togetherness. As we can see on the stage, Pope Francis, with the various representatives of the religious communities here in Bulgaria. There are six of them in all, and they consist of the Orthodox, the Armenian Church, the Jewish faith, Protestants, Muslims, and Catholics. Pope Francis greatly believes in this kind of gatherings, discussing, coming together. And recently, when he was visiting the Emirates, he described himself as a believer thirsting for peace. And indeed, as the song goes, we can make a choice and make this a better world, just you and me. On that occasion in the Emirates, Pope Francis said, "We are here to desire peace, to promote peace, and to be instruments of peace." And on this visit, we have already seen Pope Francis reaching out. He has already had a meeting with the Holy Synod, which is the structure of the Orthodox Church here. The meeting with the Holy Synod took place with the Patriarch of the Orthodox Church, Neophyte, and it offered the Holy Father yet another opportunity to reiterate that the mission entrusted to us as Christians is that we have to make this a better world, to live together. Square. There's also an olive branch right there in the middle, just below the stage, a symbol of peace. And shortly, the meeting for peace is going to start. Bulgaria itself has always been a place for peace.
Per il sole e per la luna, per le stelle e per il vento e per l'acqua e per il fuoco. Per sorella madre terra ci alimenta e ci sostiene.
Already we have frutti, i fiori, the canticle.
L'erba, per i monti e per il mare. Perché il senso della vita è cantare e lodare. E perché la nostra vita
that was composed by Saint Francis.
E per quelli che ora piangono. E per quelli che ora soffrono, e per quelli che ora nascono, e per quelli che ora muoiono, e per quelli che camminano, e per quelli che ti lodano, e per quelli che ti aspettano, e per quelli che ora cantano.
Хвален си, Господи мой, от всичките си създания, от слънцето и месечината, от звездите и от вятъра.
Praise to you, O my Lord. Yes, be praised in all your creatures. The canticle of Saint Francis, the canticle of the creatures, is being recited in the different languages. Praise to you, O my Lord. Yes, be praised in all your creatures. Sun, our brother, moon, our sister, in the stars and in the breezes, air and fire, flowing water. Thank you for the earth, our mother, she who feeds us and sustains us, for her fruits, her grace, her grass, her flowers, for the mountains and the oceans. Life is but a song, a worship, and the reason for our singing is to praise you for the music. Join the dance of all creation. For those who now weep, for those who now suffer, for those who are now born, for those who now die, for those who walk, for those who praise you, for those who wait for you, for those who sing to you. And now we see six children from the different churches carrying flames and they light a torch. Each one of them representing the six faiths of Bulgaria. Everyone prays for peace according to their own faith. It's a commitment for peace by each and everyone. So there we see the six young people who have lanterns, about six lanterns, each one of them, with the light lit from the big candle.
Andremo alla casa del Signore. E ora I nostri piedi
recitation
si fermano le tue porte,
of Psalm 122.
Gerusalemme è costruita come città salda e compatta.
I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Our feet have been standing within your gates. Jerusalem, built as a city that is bound firmly together, to which the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord, as was decreed for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. Their thrones for judgment were set, the thrones of the house of David. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May they be secure who love you. Peace be within your walls, security within your towers. For my brothers and companions, for my brothers and companions' sake, I will say, peace be with you. For the sake of the house of our God, I will seek your good.
Зарадвах се, когато ми казаха да идем в дома Господен. Ето,
now it's the Psalm 122 is going to be recited in the Bulgarian language.
Сглобен в едно. Където възлизат колената, Господните колена по закона Израилев да славят името Господне. Там стоят престолите на съда. престолите на дума Давидов. Искайте мир за Йерусалим, да добруват ония, които те обичат, да бъде мир в твоите стени, добруване в твоите чертози. Заради моите братя и моите ближни казвам мир тебе. Заради дума на Господа, нашият Бог, желая ти добро.
Now we are going to have a prayer or invocation for peace. Every group, every faith is going to make an invocation of prayer according to their way of praying. You can see with from the umbrellas it has started to rain in Sofia. There are many people participating in this event for peace. So we're going to have an invocation of peace now from the Orthodox Church of Bulgaria. The song is Grandfather Lord and is performed by a choir. Expression of the Orthodox Church of Bulgaria. In the text of the invocation of peace or the song, our Grandfather God, forgive me. I beg you from the bottom of my soul. Give me reason and understanding that I cannot go wrong. Keep away from my heart bad thoughts and evil things. Watch from the sky. Don't let any evil come to me. Give to my mother, give to my father, health, strength, and life. Peace, love to all the brothers and sisters, and love to all our people. Amen. In a nutshell, those are the lyrics of this song that we are listening to. It is an invocation of peace by the Orthodox Church of Bulgaria, performed by a choir of children. Now we'll hear the invocation of peace from a prayer by an Armenian Apostolic Bishop, the Armenian Apostolic Orthodox Church. And the bishop is praying as he says, all of you just gathered together, sing the glory of the Most Holy Trinity. In this dawn of light, praise Christ, the dawn of peace, together with the Father and the Holy Spirit, because he made the light shine. Guardian and hope of the faithful Christ our God, under the shadow of your holy and venerable cross, deliver us from the visible and invisible enemy. Make us worthy to thank you and glorify you with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and always, forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Christ has revealed himself to us. He is the God who is seated here. The voice of peace resounded. The holy greeting has been exchanged. The church has become a single soul here. The kiss was given for a full agreement. The enemy has been removed, and love has spread all over us. Now, ministers, raising your voices, give thanks together with the one consubstantial God, the one whom the seraphim praise. Very powerful invocation for prayer here from the Holy Armenian Apostolic Orthodox Church. Now we have a choir of three children singing Amen, performed in Hebrew. The children are representing the Jewish religious community. And the text or the lyrics are with a prayer, Amen, that rises up, Amen. All that breathes will praise God, Amen. Give us a blessing for peace and guard our homes. Bring us closer to the dream within us. Let us see blessing in what we do. Open our hearts so that we can always sing for you. My God, Amen. My hopes, Amen. Wrap us with your love, Amen. Give us life and guard us. Let our love be fulfilled. Bless us and shine upon our faces. Open our hearts so that we will always sing for you. To the world, Amen. To everyone, Amen. Make the human spirit strong, Amen. With prayer, Amen. To peace, Amen. To all that breathes with praise God, Amen. Cardinal Parolini there, we saw a moment ago, under an umbrella. He is the Secretary of State, the Vatican. Lovely song here, A Prayer for Peace, performed by a group of three children, the song Amen from the Jewish religious community. What is happening is the different faiths expressing their desire and longing for peace in the various religions found in Bulgaria, six of them. Right now, is a song, Prayer for Bulgaria, performed by a soloist. It is being performed on behalf of the Protestant Alliance, that is the United Evangelical Church in Bulgaria. And the lyrics are, Lord, watch over Bulgaria. Lord, bless. Not as the desert you created here. You planted her with roses. Your word is faithful. Look for every heart. Pour out your spirit again, we pray you, Lord. Listen, Bulgaria. Believe, Bulgaria. God, forgive our sins. God, have mercy on us. And in the struggle with our enemies, there be it strength and power. Listen, Bulgaria. Believe, Bulgaria. And God forgives our sins. Have mercy on us. And in the struggle with our enemies, let there be strength and power.
Боже, прости греховете ни, Боже, смили се над нас. И в борба с враговете ни, сила да имам и власт. Вярно е Твоето слово, търсиш всяко сърце. Излей духът си отново, Господи мой.
Bulgaria, performed by a soloist on behalf of the Protestant Alliance, that is the United Evangelical Churches in Bulgaria. Really an amazing afternoon, evening here. Testimony to the power of Pope Francis bringing all these people together. And now we have an invocation of peace. On behalf of the Muslims, it's a call to prayer recited by the Imam. And it says, Allah is great, repeating four times. I testify that there is no other God besides Allah. And that's repeated twice. I testify that Muhammad is his servant and envoy. Hurry up for prayer. Hurry up for salvation. Allah is great. There is no other God but Allah.
Hayya 'ala al-falah Allahu Ekber, Allahu Ekber. La ilahe illallah.
A call to prayer there, recited by an imam, a Bulgarian imam, and it's a prayer for peace among the Muslims. Now Pope Francis is going to pray a simple prayer for peace attributed to Saint Francis, the famous prayer for peace. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope.
Dove orrore, che io porti la verità. Dove disperazione,
where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy.
Dove sono le tenebre, che io porti la luce. O Maestro,
O Divine Master,
io non cerchi tanto,
grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. Prayer of Peace, composed by Saint Francis of Assisi, recited by the Holy Father here in Sofia, in the Independence Square. Now an address by the Holy Father. Dear brothers and sisters, we have prayed for peace in words inspired by Saint Francis of Assisi, who was so great in love with God, the Creator and the Father of all, a love that he showed with similar passion and deep respect for the beauty of creation and for all those whom he encountered on his pilgrim way, a love that changed his way of seeing things and helped him to realize that in everyone there is a flicker or a light born.
Amore che lo portò ad essere un autentico costruttore di pace.
It was a love that made Saint Francis become a true peacemaker. Each one of us is called to follow in his footsteps by becoming a peacemaker, an artisan of peace.
Pace che dobbiamo implorare e per la quale dobbiamo
lavorare. Peace is both a gift and a task. It must be implored and worked for, received as a blessing and constantly sought as we strive daily to build a culture in which peace is respected as a fundamental right. An active peace, fortified against all those forms of selfishness and indifference that make us put the petty interests of a few before the inviolable dignity of each person. Peace requires and demands that we adopt dialogue as our path, mutual understanding as our code of conduct, and reciprocal understanding as our method and standard. Fraternity, respecting that which brings us together,
specialmente per le generazioni che verranno. Noi questa sera,
this evening, siamo qui a pregare davanti, we are here to pray in front of these lanterns brought by the young people.
Simboleggiano il fuoco dell'amore.
They symbolize the light within us, which should be a fire of misery, of mercy, of peace among the world that we live.
illuminasse il mondo
a world that we should illuminate.
Con il fuoco dell'amore noi vogliamo sciogliere il velo delle guerre.
Flame of love,
we
are living this moment of peace on this place in the ruins of Sedica. This Sedica was a council in 343 where different faiths came to meet.
San Giuseppe di noi cattolici.
The synagogue, St. Joseph, and our brothers all met here many, many years ago. In this place, for many centuries,
appartenenti a vari gruppi culturali e religiosi per incontrarsi e discutere.
May this place be a beacon.
In questo momento le nostre voci si fondono e all'unisono.
Where our voices will be united together and give us peace. May peace be in our families, in each one of us, especially in those places where voices have been silenced by war
per la complicità schiacciante di gruppi di interesse. Tutti cooperano.
Everyone will work together to make this dream come true. Religious, political, and cultural leaders, may each of us, wherever we may be, in all that we do, be able to say, Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. It is a plea. The dream of Pope St. John the 23rd, may it come true. The dream of earth, where peace is always home. Let us share in that aspiration and with the witness of our lives. Let us say, Pacem in Terris, peace on earth to all those whom the Lord loves. The words of Pope Francis at the end of this peace gathering, which brought together six different faiths of Bulgaria to pray for peace. And we have seen each one of them pray according to their faith. Great Alleluia. Alleluia, for the Lord God reigns. The King of the world has become the kingdom of our Lord, and of his Christ he shall reign forever and ever, King of kings and Lord of lords. Alleluia. It's a Paschal Alleluia song being sung by a Bulgarian choir together with the people. Slowly winding us out of this extraordinary gathering. Pope Francis bringing together all the faiths, the major faiths in Bulgaria, to pray for peace.
Thank you.
Pope Francis now beginning to take his leave as gives the kiss of peace, embraces all the brothers who are on stage, the brothers and sisters. It shows that peace is possible in the world. Pope Francis is a Pope of gestures, and with this powerful gesture, I think he shows the world what is possible, and that there is no need for all the acrimony, the recrimination in this world. The Holy Father stepping down from the stage to the Paschal Alleluia. He has reminded us that the fire, the lanterns that the children were bearing, should burn within our hearts and should become a beacon of mercy, love, and peace wherever we go. Pope Francis, going back, and now in his vehicle, at the end of this prayer for peace, which I must say has been a very rainy one, and we see all those umbrellas. This piazza, this square, has a lot of symbolism for the Bulgarians. And he reminded us of the importance of peace. Within a few kilometers, within a few meters here, it is important that there is the mosque, which is nearby, and the cathedral. They are all within nearby. So that concludes our broadcast this evening from Sofia. Pope Francis' meeting for peace with the different religions. My name is Father Paul Samasumo. Would like to thank in a very special way all those who have followed this broadcast, CBS TV, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, EWTN TV, Net TV, and Catholic TV. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ.